Hello everyone, Sarasu TCG here. Thanks for tuning in to another video. If you haven't watched the deck profile video to this hand testing video, you should definitely do. If you have already, thank you very much for tuning in again. So we gonna do some hand testing now, because this deck is, I would say, a bit unusual, or at least it's a deck you don't see very often, and if you haven't build it yourself, you probably won't understand it what to do here. So, and I thought the best way to show it is some hand testing, you know, some playing with it, so you can see what I was thinking when building this and what tactic you should follow. You can go with this deck first or second, more or less doesn't matter. It's a bit better if you go second. So we also would go second now, so we can draw six cards. I have to play it a little bit carefully, because the camera is a little bit in a dangerous spot right now. So six cards, because we went second. So we started off pretty good. We have one Torghat from the Underworld, one Fiendish Rhino Warrior, one Dark Spirit of Malice, one Gemini Ablation, very good, we got this, one Dark Spirit of Banishment, and another Torghat from the Underworld. So, of course, I guess you know what we are gonna do. We gonna now summon the Torghat from the Underworld and activate the effect, search a level 3 Fiend Type monsters and special summon it. We go. So the target for this always depends on what state of game you are. In the early game, as now, you should always go for the Fiendish Rhino Warrior. And a little bit later in the game, if you have already your level 8 monsters in the grave and you have not a Dark Spirit of Banishment or Malice in your grave, you should definitely go for the Dark Spirit of Malice or Banishment. But either way, you can also send the Dark Spirit of Banishment or Malice with him to the grave later. So, we have our Fiendish Rhino Warrior now. Shuffled again. We go in Xyz 3, of course. And this is gonna be our Dante. So we go on Dante in defense mode. We activate the effect of Dante, of course. You could also go in attack mode and attack then. Okay, let's say we go in attack mode. We go in attack mode. Activate of Dante. Detach one material. We're gonna detach the Fiendish Rhino Warrior, of course. And then select the number from 1 to 3 and the top 3 cards. We always select 3 because we want our cards in the grave. So we'll select 3, send 3 cards from the deck to the grave. We have very good if this is in the grave. 1 Curse Necrophia. This is not so good if this is in the grave. 1 Dark Necrophia. And 1 Dark Sanctuary. And the effect of the Fiendish Rhino Warrior also activates. We can now send 1 Fiend Type monster from your grave to the our deck to the grave, except Fiendish Rhino Warrior. And now this would be the target. For we have, as we saw before, we have already a Dark Spirit of Malice in our hand, so we're gonna send a Dark Spirit of Banishment to the grave. Okay, so now let's say our opponent activates an effect, any kind of effect, doesn't matter. Our opponent activates any kind of effect or chained it to Dante, then we can activate the Dark Spirit of Malice, because it says if your opponent activates effect, any effect, it's a quick effect. So this guy is a quick effect. We can discard this card from our hand or send it from the field to the grave and special summon 1 level 8 feed time monster from our graveyard. And luckily, a few minutes ago, we cannot special summon Dark Necrophia. We cannot do that because we have to summon this one time correctly. But we can summon the Curse Necrophia. So our opponent activates effect. We discard Dark Spirit of Malice. And we're gonna special summon our Kersnegfrir. And so fast we have, so quick we can get out our Necrophyr. Okay. So then he activates whatever he activates, I don't know. Normal summoned we have already. So we're gonna set the Gemini Ablation. We lit a little bit more of space here because it's getting a bit too much right now. Alright. That's it. In our hand is another Torgel from the Underworld. Dark Spirit of Banishment, very nice. And another Fiendish Windwarrior. Now we could go into the battle phase. Let's say we do that. We attack with Kersnegfrir. And then we attack with Dante. Main phase 2, Dante goes into defense position. But that doesn't bother us very much because I exceed monster battle, so we gonna rank up to Zombies. And then end turn and pass turn. So now it's his main phase, he summoned a monster, and that's now very nice. Gemini Ablation. What does this do? I guess not many of you are familiar with this. We can, of course, we have to activate it, and then in the main phase, in either player's main phase, and you can do this in your opponent's main phase, and of course in your main phase, you can discard one card and then activate one of those effects. For us, only the first effect is interesting, the second effect doesn't matter and is not possible. We discard one card and then we can summon one Gemini monster as an effect monster. It instantly gains its effect from our deck as a special summon from our deck. Very broken. So we're gonna do that. We discard our Fiendish Windwarrior. You're gonna know where this is going. And we special summon a Gemini monster from our deck. And this is mostly is gonna be, we could go for the Red Eyes Archfiend of Lightning. It's a Zwilling, is German, means Gemini. This is basically Raigeki. His effect is basically Raigeki. But we go for the Doom Shaman. Let's see an English version, because then I don't have to translate it. I just have to read it with the Doom Shaman. And then, because we discarded Fiendish Windwarrior, when he goes to the grave, we can send a Fiend monster from the deck to the grave. And we also gonna do that. We gonna send probably, actually, this, I don't know. You could go for him, or for another Curse Necrophyr, or for Belial. Let's say we go with a Belial. Okay, we could put Belial in the grave, and that again activates an effect if we do that. Let's give it a quick shuffle, because if we send a level 8 fiend type monster to the grave and we have Dark Spirit of Malice or Dark Spirit of Banishment in our grave, we can add both of them to our hand. And we do that. We add this and this to our hand. This is the effect of those two. We do that. And then we did this all in opponent's turn. And now it's his turn again. He plays. And then he activates the effect. And you're gonna know what we are doing now. He activates the effect, so we can activate our effect from Dark Spirit of Malice again. Discard it from the hand and special summon one level 8 Fiend monster from the grave. We do that because we just sent Belial from the deck to the grave a few minutes ago. Yeah, that's so far. It goes on and on and on. Whatever. Maybe he battles, I don't know. Or he don't battle. Whatever. Now it's our turn again. And now it could get out of hand very quickly. Because now we can activate again Gemini Ablation. We do that. We discard Dark Spirit of Banishment. We can special summon another Gemini monster directly from our deck. We go with the Red Red Eyes Archfiend of Lightning. Gonna special summon this one. Again, a quick shuffle. And of course he would have destroyed some monsters or whatever. But just to show it you a little bit better, we won't go into too much detail. So now, Tür, what can we do now? We have two level 8 monsters and two level 6 monsters. And I guess you know where this is going now. First, we go into level 8. Pah, that's totally up to you now. You could go into Dingirsu, into the Lancelot number 23, into Zombie Vampire even. I guess we go with Galaxy S Cypher Blade Dragon. No, sorry, that's not possible. We need the... Where is he? Cypher X? Cypher Dragon, sorry. With the Galaxy Eyes Cypher Dragon. We have two level 8 monsters. Galaxy Cypher Dragon. So now we activate the effect of Galaxy Eyes Cypher Dragon. Detach one material. We're gonna detach Cursed Necrophil. To steal our opponent's monster. Let's take this. For now, this is the opponent's monster now, and we discarded a level 8 fiend type monster was sent to the grave, so we can add Dark Spirit of Banishment and of Malice back to our hand. Very nice, so we can start this combo over and over again. So we activated his effect, we got the monster from him. This is now treated as Galaxy as Cypher Dragon, so we can rank up on this one. Oops, sorry. To the Galaxy Eyes Cypher X Dragon. And we do that, of course. Then, let's say we rank up on him too. We rank up to the Galaxy Eyes Photon Dragon. Activate the effect of Galaxy Eyes Photon Dragon. Detach one material. To destroy one face-up card on the opponent's side of the field, we do that. We won't rank up again, because now we're gonna activate the effect of the Red Eyes Archfiend of Lightning. It says, once per turn, you can destroy all face-up monsters on the opponent's side of the field with a lower death than his ATK. So all monsters with a lower death of 2500 are destroyed, so basically Raigeki. We do that. Hopefully we can destroy a lot. Then we activate Doom Shaman's effect. He says, once per turn, you can special summon one fiend type monsters from your hand or from either player's graveyard. When this card is removed from the field, destroy all fiend type monsters special summoned by this effect. We're gonna activate it. We special summon the Curse Necrophere. Again, oh, you can't see it, but over here is the Cursed Necrophere. Now we have a full field, actually. So now we go into Xyz 6 with Doom Shaman and the Red Eyes Archfiend of Lightning. And we go into our, where we see, Chinzo Laird. Oops, that was the lamp. Chinzo Laird. So, and Chinzo Laird. And, of course, this effect now doesn't count, because we used it as an Xyz summon. So it didn't leave the field, so the Cursed Necrophere won't be destroyed. So, Chinzo Laird says, I can detach one material from this card and then take control of one monster my opponent controls. I hope he still controls one. But he cannot attack and his effects cannot be activated. And if a trap... If a face-up trap is on the field, I can tribute one monster. I can tribute one monster from either player's side. So I can tribute his monsters if he has a problematic monster. And if you do that, I can destroy a card on the field. We only activate the first effect. We're gonna detach one material. Take control of one monster. And now, because we have Cursed Necrophere here, level 8, and great thing is, the Zombie Vampire says, If we control a monster from the opponent, we can treat it as level 8 if we Xyz summon this zombie vampire. We do that. We gonna Xyz summon. Yeah, place is running low now. Into the zombie vampire. Okay. You see now, and we have still a lot of options left now. We can use Chinzo's second effect because we control a face-up trap card to tribute any monster if he has monsters left. We can activate Zombie Vampire's effect to send the top four cards from either player's deck to the grave and special summon another monster if you want to. We can rank up here to destroy another card on his side of the field, whatever we want we can do now. So, and to show our hand, what is left on our hand, even if we have to activate Zeus effect, we have Banishment and Malice on our hand, so all the Fiendtail monsters we can easily get back from the graveyard. We have Gemini Ablation still here. Okay, no, if we activate Zeus, then we cannot activate Gemini Ablation because it's gone, but we can start over again with the tour guide from the underworld. Okay, I won't go too much in detail now because the video is otherwise a little bit too long. I hope you saw what's possible with this deck. Of course, you're free to modify it or whatever with your likes or what you like to play more. Yeah, I hope it helped you a bit. I hope I wasn't too fast. I guess not. You're familiar with the game. Not too much talking. Thank you very much for watching. Have fun with it and goodbye.